My name is Chinyere. You are most welcome to my channel. Yes, I live in the UK also. So please, there are a lot of things that go in our mind whenever someone is leaving his or her original country to the Western world. The feeling that you are going away from your country is usually something of excitement, something that comes with great expectations. Yes, so there are a lot of things that I'll be talking about in this video regarding the truth no one tells you about life in the UK, life in the United Kingdom. So number one is this, the unrealistic expectations. A lot of us think that living abroad means that one is successful, one has made it in life, no more poverty, no more lacks. But this is not true. Life in the UK is absolutely different, and considering that they have the highest currency valuation when it comes to pound, when you make pounds in the overseas, in the UK, and you spend it in the UK, is totally nothing compared to when you take the pounds back to your country in Africa. For instance, you take the pound back to Nigeria, 100 pound in Nigeria, if you convert it, you know how much that is. Then 100 pounds is something that you could use to go into a restaurant, have food, it can buy you lunch, dinner, and then probably you shop with it for your grocery for the month. Yeah, that's fine. But in Nigeria, when you convert that money, you know what you'll be doing with 100 pounds in Nigeria. So it's not always a bed of roses in the UK. Secondly, you must meet someone. Yes, homesickness is a reality once you arrive the UK. I remember my first time in the UK, that was around 8 years ago. I woke up in the morning, I was like, am I truly in England? So you must definitely be missing some routine abroad because it's quite different. You wake up, you look through the window, you see the white snow, you see the tranquility of the environment. Everywhere is so calm. You are looking for the people that live on that street. Then you begin to miss Nigeria. The noise in Nigeria, the neighborhood. It's not like that in this very country. Number three on my list is one of the truth no one tells you about living in the UK. As you arrive in the country, I beg of you, do not fake your accent. Even if you've been watching British movies and all them stuff, you come here to speak super, 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 they wouldn't even understand you. They keep saying, can you say that again? Can you repeat yourself? Don't fake it. Rather speak slowly so that they can pick up what you're saying. This is just a piece of advice because you might be surprised that the English you speak is different from what they speak. Yes, that's it. Number four, F word, name calling, body shaming is not something that is allowed in this country. Somewhere in my country, you would see a fat person, you can call that person fat. Why are you still eating? Look at how you are looking. At work the other day, the person that ate the food most when we had our lunch, the tea, the in-between, that's the dessert or whatever that we had. The person that ate most was the fattest among us. In my country, where I've come from, somebody would be like, oh, girl, would you stop eating? Are you not watching this weight where the wrench shoe? Can't you just watch your weight? You don't do that here because it will give the person depression. They take it so serious. You don't call names. You don't use F words. It's not allowed. Number five, friendship is not an easy thing to start up here. Yes, because everyone is totally minding their business in this country, and they have this kind of cultural variation, social life, the way you socialize wherever you are coming from in your own country is different from the way they socialize here. Yeah, so you don't get to see your neighbors. Your neighbors, they don't even know your name, they don't know your parents, they don't know who you are. But where I am coming from, they know your parents, they know all your sibs, so that whenever you commit shit on the streets, before you know it, your parents, they are aware of whatever you've done on the streets, even in the school. It's not like that in this place. Mingling with people, it's such a different stuff to get started with. Yeah, but with time, you would definitely get along, especially if you're here for school and if you're here to work. Definitely, you would get to meet with people. Yes, that you get interacted with or stay connected with people from work, your schoolmates. Yeah. Six, basic things might totally be difficult for you, especially having to navigate around the streets, going shopping, finding your way in the aisles, as in trying to get what you want. It might be totally different because it's different from where you're coming from. Yes, I must say a few days ago I missed my way. Yeah, I had to walk for over an hour despite using Google Map and all them stuff. So sometimes it might be a bit difficult for you getting your way around the town, around the street. Yes, you definitely need to. You would definitely get lost one or two times before you start getting used to places around now. So another bitter truth about living in the UK that no one tells you is that most Christians, especially the ones coming from Nigeria, you know, Nigerians are very much religious. Is it cautious? Yes, or conscience? Yes, we are very churches. You know, unfortunately, when we come to the UK, most of us will stop going to church. Why? Because we tend to work during the weekend, Sunday, bank holidays and all that stuff. We take up those shifts that white people are dropping. They don't joke with their off days, especially weekends. They don't like working during the weekends. But you find that most Africans, they like to work during this weekend because they get paid double of, assuming that you are supposed to pay £5 per hour. Nobody pays £5 per hour anyway. If you work during the weekend, they pay you £10 per hour. Yes, times it to how many hours you're working. So most of us Christians from Nigeria, we stop going to church on Sundays, basically because we feel that we earn more when we work on Sundays. And not only that, we have arrived in the UK, you know, we don't have much things to pray for. You're not praying against accidents. You're not praying against your neighbor whom you tag the witch and all them stuff, or your grandpa, grandma, your village people. You have overcome all them stuff, but that's not really nice. Yes, next thing on my list is this. So here, flu is taken very serious in this country. When you hear flu, oh, that's cold, you know. Cold, catarrh, cough is something very serious in this country. You can even take, get a sick leave because you have catarrh and cold. Yes, in my country, it's not like that. We don't regard that. We only have malaria from the mosquito bite. That's when you see people taking medication or staying up from work. But here, the cold, it penetrates through your bone marrow, I must show you. So I think it's better you take your flu jab before coming, that's flu vaccine, before coming into this country. It will help you a
Yeah, this
lot.
is another bitter truth that no one tells you. Your relative might not help you in this country. So why entering the UK? You don't have in mind you have an uncle, you have an aunt, therefore you're going to the house to squat and blah blah blah. Oh, more, they will not help you. Sorry to say that I'm being blunt about this because they also have their financial challenges and needs. Okay, this is abroad. This is not Nigeria where you do uncle, cousin, this and that. An hour counts in this money. You in this country, you get paid per hour. You know what that means? So they make their budget and they take it serious. No space for you. If perchance they accommodate you, could be for a specific period of time, 1 month, 2 months, begin to find your way. Yes, and you find anyone that accommodates you more than that, the person is just fantastically good. I had such opportunity. Thank you to Sandra. When I came into the UK in 2010, Sandra accommodated me. Even Joe Easy and family, I spent about 4 5 days at Joe Easy. Trish, thank you. That's the wife to Joe. They accommodated me. Before Sandra took over, I spent 4 months at Sandra's before I got my own apartment. But I'm telling you the fact, do not depend on anyone. Do not bank your hope on my uncle, my cousin. Work hard and get your way through. Start living like an independent adult. That's what you are. Once you're 18 here, you don't grow. So don't expect uncles and cousins. Don't just give them trouble. Yes, grow up. Yeah, I'm not being mean. Sorry about that. Another thing is this: you don't watch TV for free in this country. I've made a video the other day. They got us letter regarding TV license, and basically, you do not stream any live program on BBC for free. It requires you to get a license before you can watch them stuff. Yes, because it's punishable in this country. It's an offense to be streaming all them stuff on TV without having permits to do so. Next on my list is independent lifestyle. You are on your own. OYO, or your is your name. Everyone is minding their business. You don't have, in fact, you don't have any need going to your neighbor to knock. Do you have matches? Do you have salt? Buy everything you have to buy. You come home, you realize. If you're a student, you might not even have access to sink. Though you might have a shared kitchen, but you have your own space in the kitchen. No, so take all these things serious. no time to interact with your neighbors and all them stuff. Let me not dwell on this for long.
Yes, another thing is this budgeting hack in this country. Budgeting is a serious stuff. If you are someone that have this careless way of spending money, it's not here in the UK, because you definitely need to budget your expenditure, your expenses within the week. There are so much you pay for in this country, I must tell you. Your bills, your electricity bill, water bill, the rent, and all what have you. I can't even name all of them. So if you're the one that you always bring in at £10, you're spending this, this, make a list. Within 2-3 months, you make a list, or you take a list of, you take note of what you spend. You should be able to have your total budget within that month. I've started hours too, you know. So basically, you learn and plan how you spend your money in this country. As you're always going broke and bankrupt. Yes. So another point is this. Tea in this country is different from tea in Nigeria, my own country. Sorry, I'm a Nigerian. Yeah. So the tea we drink, what we know as tea in my country, Nigeria, is Milo and powdered milk. Here, when you go to a British person's house or even at work or anywhere, what they make you here is Lipton tea bag and then liquid milk. That's fresh milk, not our own kind of liquid thick milk that is sweet. This one here is totally tasteless. So that's what they give you here as cup of tea. Yeah, so it's totally different. Another thing they do not tell you about living in this country is that titles do not matter. Mr. Chief, Professor, Doctor. If you are a doctor, my brother, keep it that in your pocket. Here they address you by your name straight ahead. Paul, John, Catherine, Lucy. They don't care whether you have PhD or whatever. And it makes it totally easier for you to interact with your employer, your lecturer, your work colleagues. At work, my manager, one of my managers, is always taking up making teas for the staff. You can imagine, you wouldn't even know it's the manager, you know. So even at school, your lecturers, you go to their offices, you sit down with them, they cross their leg, you cross yours. Oh my goodness, it's such a beautiful thing, if you ask me. Yeah, particularly, these are some of the sweet things no one tells you about living in the UK. I hope you get used to them once you come in here, you know. So please, if you are stopping by for the first time, do not forget to like, comment, leave your questions. I will be glad to make videos about whichever topic you want me to make videos on. Remember to subscribe and keep staying connected for more videos like this. Thank you and bye for now.